Roman, my cousin. I'd really like a cab if you could send one to me.
You need walk no longer. There's a cab coming to you.
So, can you take me to Applewhite Street?
I'm going to hate this drive. You better be enjoying yourself back there, because... I hope you enjoyed your free ride. I certainly did not enjoy the driving of you.
Florian, open the door. Nemoj desi, Peder.
Govor Ingleski, and I told you it's Bernie.
Then Bernie, open the door. What's going on?
Come in, come in. The haters are trying to kill me. I can't stand it. I won't stand it. It's not fair. I'm just being me.
Bernie, what are you talking about?
I came to this country to be myself. To get away from small-minded, angry, macho pricks.
Oh, like me?
Yes! Well, no. Well, you know what I mean. It was hardly the most progressive place. How does my hair look?
Fine.
I put a rinse in. Tawdry night.
Nice.
Bryce found some gray hairs. If he leaves me, I'll kill myself.
Forget about your hair, Florian.
Bernie.
What's the problem?
Someone is threatening to kill me. Every time I go out jogging and doing aerobics or playing Ultimate Disc, some guy comes up and threatens me. He's loco.
Why is he threatening you?
Because... I think just because I'm fabulous.
What?
I keep thinking I'm being followed and I don't know why. I'm a prisoner in my own home!
Okay, Bernie, let's go out and have a look.
Ooh, I'm so glad you've come back into my life.
That's cool, but listen, you and I don't know each other.
How can you say that? I thought you were different.
Because we want this guy to attack you. Come on.
Oh.
The haters are in Middle Park, hon. You're still in great shape. You work out?
Not really. I keep active, you know?
Is there a name for that fitness plan? I'd take a class if I could be guaranteed buns like yours.
It's called getting chased by the cops and being errand boy for the mob.
Ah.
We're going for a jog, Nico. Try to keep up and stay back, too. We don't want to be rumbled.
Come on, slow, coach.
Try a bit of subtlety, honey. Keep up, honey! Hiya!
Take me home now! Hey, I wanna grab your hand, baby!
I'm about done with you, homo!
Ah! Ah!
on someone who'll fight back.
What's your problem, fag lover?
Whatever you say, buddy. Unfortunately, for hitting my friend, I'm going to kick the shit out of you.
Pedicure or something.
Get him, Nico! I want him to suffer for every gray hair and worry line! I can't believe that Bryce hasn't ended things already! I'm disgusting! I've gotten fat and ugly, Nico! You should have seen me when I first got here!
I knew you before you got here!
I'm not dressed for jail! We need to get out of here! This is horrible!
He's not going to attack you again.
No, he ain't. You're an absolute sweetie, Niko Bellic. I never would have thought it. Vidimos il scoro div Niko Veci.
Can't people drive in this car? I'm sorry to hear that.
We gotta discuss something. I put you on the visitors list here? You come down.
Hey, are you Law Chick? We met online. I'm Niko Bellic.
Hey, Niko, it's Kiki. Kiki Jenkins.
It gets around.
Your clothes are cool.
They'll do, you know.
So, it's nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Yes, I knew you'd be nice from your email.
How?
I could just tell. I mean, not that I read too much into it. This is just a casual date, you know? Casual.
Sure.
But, well, it was nice. It's strange. You always want something to be like it is in the movies, don't you?
Me? No. Movies are dull. I cannot take grown men playing dressing cop games very seriously.
Well, I do. I'm a girl who wants to make it in the big city, you know? I grew up in the suburbs, bored out of my mind, and now I'm here trying to make a difference. I'm not naive, but...
You sound pretty naive.
I'm an idealist, if that's what you mean.
Maybe that's what I mean.
I came here and I thought it would be different.
You and me both.
I thought it would be like I imagined, but I'm really lonely. I mean, it's nice to be out with you.
Good.
I'm part of the union. Yeah, like you said. I am so sick of worrying about terrorism.
Ricky Gervais, it is then.
Shit is bananas.
Mr. Ricky Gervais!
Whoa. Oh, thank you. Yeah, it really is me. Calm down. I do a lot of work for charity. I don't do enough. They say you can always do more. But I look at it like this. It's a pain, isn't it? Nothing in it for me. Do a lot of work for cancer. That's my chosen charity. Do a lot of work for people with cancer. and they're welcome to it. But I will say this, if I ever get cancer myself, I'm gonna walk into the nearest hospital and go, right, I paid for that machine, get that little bald fucker off it. Talking of little bald fuckers, I did the teenage cancer gig last year. What? No, I'd done it 2 years before, but they called again last year. We're still ill. You lasted. It's a great gig though. The kids with cancer get in for free and you meet them afterwards and, you know, they come backstage and you sign stuff for them. And I was doing the gig this last year. And I looked down and I recognised one of them. And I thought, oh yeah, he came backstage 2 years ago. He was telling me about his illness and he said he was 18. And that was then, that was 2 years ago, so now he must be 20. So why the fuck is he still a teenager? And I was doing the gig and he was laughing along. And I was thinking, yeah, you laugh it up, mate. I was fuming. And eventually it got too much for me. And I went, all right, mate, I recognise you. I went, hello, yeah. You came backstage 2 years ago? I went, yeah. I said, you said you were 18 then? I went, yeah, so you're 20 now? I went, yeah. I said, get out. And I called security and they came. He struggled, but he was weak. I mean, I think they'd worked out because they, although they had trouble getting hold of him to start with, but eventually the, his drip nearly had someone's eye out. The crowd started booing. I went, hear that? They don't want to see someone like you take the piss out of me. No money. I do a lot of work for AIDS as well. I've worked for AIDS charities for many years, from the mid to late 80s. And back then, people, they didn't know what this new disease, what's this new disease called AIDS? I mean, it's gone from strength to strength now, hasn't it? It's gone global, it's doing very well. Got its own day and everything. World AIDS Day, 1st of December. I don't think it'd ever take off like Christmas. We don't do anything in our house, no decorations. You can't even get a card. They don't do, sorry, you got AIDS cards. They don't exist. Fascinating fact about AIDS. People always learn stuff from my lectures. This is absolutely true. The HIV virus was actually a combination of two separate viruses in rhesus monkeys, and it formed a rudimentary form of AIDS. And this was passed to chimpanzees. Sometimes chimps will get a bloodlust and they'll eat a rhesus monkey, and it sort of mutated and evolved in chimpanzees. And because we're 98.6% genetically identical to chimpanzees, it was able to be passed to humans. And the first human contracted AIDS when he was chopping up chimp meat and cut his finger. Although that's the excuse I'd have given. You'd have to come up with something, wouldn't you? The doctor goes, well, you're the first human to contract AIDS. You go, is that bad? Yeah, it can be. Well, how would I have got that? Two ways. One, you were fucking a chimp up the arse. No way. What's the other way I could have got it? Well, I suppose you could have been chopping up a chimp and cut your finger, that one. I bet he went straight out to the jungle and found that chimp. And went, oi, you fucking gave me AIDS. I gave you what? You gave me AIDS. I gave you a blowjob, shush. No, I got AIDS from you. Well, how did I get AIDS? From eating monkeys. I don't eat monkeys. You're either eating them or fucking them. I was eating them. It tastes like chicken. That's how it happened. Thanks very much. Good night.
But plenty all the same. You maniac! good time, Nico. I can't tell you how nice it is to be taken out on a date.
Well, maybe I'll take you out again. Give me your number. I'll see you soon.
Hey, buddy, where you headed? Sure thing. Here we are.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, kid?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm sorry about your brother.
Me and Francis were never exactly close, but he was my brother, and it hurts. Poor bastard. He believed in something once. That's a hell of a lot better than me, I guess. Fuck, I'll miss him.
How are you? In here?
Fine. Time of my life. Goddamn time of my life.
What you up for?
Racketeer, an armed robbery, a bunch of shit I never did because I was always a well-behaved family man who occasionally liked to drink, but nothing more.
Of course, like us all.
Like us all.
But the thing is, I think I should make some changes in my life. Stop with the drink.
Put it down. Stop hanging out with the wrong sort.
Can you help me do that? It is a final chance at redemption.
Look, whatever you want, I will do my best to help.
Good.
Give Packy a call. He'll explain what, I need guidance with the most. The areas where I have strayed furthest from the path.
See ya. Your brother told me to call you.
Jerry wants us to kidnap old man Ancelotti's daughter. Some fake tan, dyed-haired, Guido-loving slut by the name of Grace. She's selling her tasteful pink felter on Auto Erotica at the moment. Get online, organize a viewing, and snatch that bitch. When you got her, bring her to a place we got on an alleyway off Sacramento.
I can do that.
You can do anything, Nico. Don't let her on that you're kidnapping her near her place, though. Play along with a test drive for a while to get her out of there. It's a real mobbed-up area, and they'll come down on you damn heavy.
Aren't you going to help?
One of my fucking brothers just got shot, and another one's in the pen. Someone's gotta be with my mom.
Thank you. where you're going. Don't make me have to take you down.
I'm calling about the car.
Customized place on Babbitt's Drive. You don't sound like the sort of man who drives a pink convertible.
Well, I can't resist the bargain.
Calls about the car, the one with the sexy accent.
You mind if I take a test drive?
You can test drive whatever you want. I love riding in cars with you European types. My family's from Italia, you know, somewhere in the south. Why don't you drive towards the south coast? We can enjoy the day. Shit for brains, how am I gonna sell this? So, you like the car? I didn't think a manly guy like you would drive something like this. You got a wife or a girlfriend or something?
I'm picking this up for a friend.
Yeah? What a gentleman. You don't meet guys like you in the city no more. All the good men are gone, is what my dad says.
Your dad sounds real old school. You and him close?
Nah, not really. He's great and all, it's just I don't like his tough guy friends. I only hang out with gay guys, you know? At least they won't try and get in your pants every 10 seconds. Not that I don't like guys trying to get in my pants. I appreciate fun as much as the next girl. Maybe even more than the next girl.
You having fun at the moment?
Maybe too much fun. Call me Gracie, by the way.
Sure thing, Gracie.
How's it going then, sweetie?
All right. But what I'm here for hasn't really started yet.
You've been test driving for a while, so I can only guess that you're interested in something other than the car.
I am. I'm here to kidnap you, Grace Ancelotti. I don't want to hurt you, so remain fucking calm.
Fuck you! I'm dialing my daddy. He's gonna do more than test drive your ass, prick!
Try to call him without a phone. Fuck down, their little birdies will be eating your brains off the dashboard tomorrow morning.
The moment I saw you, I knew you were an overcompensator. Making up for your one-inch punch with fast cars and guns. I'm getting sick of you, you creep!
That makes two of us!
I'll scratch your fucking eyes out!
Scratch my fucking balls!
This easy.
Then I'm not going to either.
I'm going back to my daddy.
Only when he pays the fucking ransom.
You seen the last of me.
I really wish that was true.
With the wrong girl, asshole. I am Gracie Ancelotti, and I...
Shut up! Peace at last.
Warm Rasta. Yo, you wanna go down to the strip club, Mr. Mincha?
No can do, Jacob. I've got a girl with me, and, I don't think it would be appropriate. Let's speak soon, though, huh?
Who
There he is. Stevie, dump the car. I'll take this piece of ass.
Guys, the beach better be worth the trouble.
Papa's got some serious cash. And he pissed off Gerald. That's reason enough for me.
Well, they better pay quick. I hate to think of the fight she'll put up if you try to cut her fingers off. Gordon has the bitch. I'm done with her.
Thanks, Nico. My brother will be a happy man. I'll get things in motion. Be in touch.
I grew up in a war. This means nothing.
You desensitized punk!
Who you waving at?
Feds, I think. They always drive past at this time.
Does that worry you?
When you marry a dragon, you gotta expect a few knights are gonna turn up to try to slay him. Jackasses. All of them. All of you.
Nice talking with
Whatever. You have fun. Pick a swell guy to kill. Hopefully someone with a young family who really miss him.
Hey!
Hey!
Is Mr. Pegorino around?
Sure. I'll get him. Boss!
Anthony, will you shut up? In fact, will you fuck off? Go on, get out of here. Don't come back till you get a brain implant or something.
I'm sorry. I'm
nice to see you, Nico.
You too.
I got a couple of things I want to talk to you about. First up, can you kill this shithead?
Sure.
Second, come in here.
Oh, fuck.
So, listen, we got a bit of a problem with the Pavanos.
Yes, I noticed that at your meeting with them.
The way they look at us, we're bottom feeders. Always have been. We ain't a real family to them, just a bunch of Guernsey Goombas. When things are cool, we're getting fucked.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Sure. Listen, some of their boys are in town today. Gonna collect their piece of an Alderney bookie ring. Where it is, they're at the diner, an actor. Find them and follow them to the meet. You disrupt it, and I'll let you keep the money. But make sure you hit the Pavanos real hard. Kabish?
Yeah, kabish.
Thank you.
Yeah!
think that guy works for the Pegorinos. God, they must be desperate. Let's lose him on the way to the meet.
I got that stuff, Jimmy.
Well done, my boy. I hope you made him suffer. Take
from that vault on a Pecorino turf. Is there a nice little haul in it for you?
All right.
Well, maybe you'll give me a little taste then. And something up the left.
Good thing I'm not Italian.
My new
working for a mafia family. They're scum.
The Pecorino? They're not a family. Gravelli is the only man who can get what you need done. He's in Shotland Medical Center. Tell him you were sent by a mutual friend. He's expecting.
He's got work. He pays. That's about it.
Yeah? Well, remember who made the introduction. Remember who brought you in. Don't you forget about me. Maybe you want to pass something up to me. Pay me some tribute.
Sorry, Ray. I'm freelance. I don't buy into that tribute stuff. This work has many disadvantages, but, hey, at least it's tax-free.
Hey, Tommy, check this out. Seven horse, seven race,
hey,
Joe
Phil. Strong.
What? Hey, pal, what's going on?
Not too much. How are you?
I'm good. Want to walk and talk?
Sure.
Tommy, give me a call if my big buddy calls. Tell him I went out to get some fresh air.
No problem.
Ridiculous! I'm a grown man walking around like a chump. I'm sorry about this.
Hey, no problem.
So you're a friend of Ray's?
A friend? No, I do some work for him.
No, I mean a friend.
I don't understand. Whatever you say, he's a slime ball, but he pays.
Sure, pal, sure. Listen to me. The thing about Ray is, he's a good earner. He talks a lot of shit, but he's a good earner. Dabish.
He's a rat doing an impression of a man.
That's pretty good.
Phil! Phil!
Wad, what do you want?
Mr. Boss, said you gotta head down to docks. Emergency. Said you'd understand.
Ah, shit, it's 3 days early. Man on the mia, what am I gonna do?
What's the problem?
Nico, I'm gonna have to take a chance with you, pal.
Okay.
Come on, let's go.
Okay, listen, there's a truck waiting for us. It's under the overpass off Catskill Avenue. Drive us there.
You scan this thing for bugs? No, but we can be pretty sure it's clean. Chill out.
All right. It's just that if we get caught on this one, you and me is going down for a long time. And that means that certain people is gonna assume we're wrecked, which means we'll get whacked.
You're working with the wrong people if you expect.
expect them to whack you if you go inside. Where's the trust, Phil?
It's about survival. If someone who knew what I knew got flipped, then the whole organization will go down. Whacking someone who catches some heavy time is just an insurance policy. And it don't help that not everyone in the organization is pulling in the same direction.
You mean that someone in the family would see someone else going inside as an opportunity to get ahead?
You're a smart guy. Anyways, excuse me if I want to be absolutely sure that we got our asses covered.
You're excused. What are we doing?
We're taking a load of product off of some Russians the enchiladas have been dealing with. You was helping those Irish idiots cause some beef between the enchiladas and their Albanian muscle a while back.
Since that little love affair ended, they've been getting this Russian guy to supply them with sea.
We just got the heads up that a shipment has arrived in Liberty City by boat.
That's what the talk about the ducks was.
Exactly. We're taking the sea off the Russians so they can't deliver it to the enchiladas.
Sounds straightforward. We think...
All right, this is the truck.
Must be a shitload of coke we're taking.
It should be a lot of sugar. But that ain't the only reason why we're taking this truck. Some of my boys stole it from the enchiladas this morning. It's the one the Russians are expecting to come pick up the sea. We should be able to turn up and have them load it up for us. Then we drive away, no questions asked.
I don't know if anyone would give away a load of coke without asking any questions. Even Russian coke runners ain't that stupid.
Yeah, sure, this is just plan A. It's the one Jimmy P worked out. You and me know it ain't gonna work, and that the only way we're gonna be able to leave that place with the sugar is if all the Russians in there are dead.
So why don't we use a more subtle approach? Not just drive right into the middle of it.
Because these is the orders, and we gotta follow them. That's the way things work. You ain't gonna be happy about everything you get told to do, are you?
You're the boss. It ain't like I'm working for free.
No, you ain't, and I ain't neither. That's why we gotta at least try to do what we're told to do. You're gonna learn that there ain't much in this life that you got control of. Whether you're putting yourself in harm's way because that's the way the skipper wants it done, or you're staying away from your kids because of a stupid court order and a malicious bitch of an ex-wife, there ain't that much control in anything.
I've been around long enough to know that there are some things that we don't have a choice about. But there's other times where you got to look at something and make a decision for yourself. I can't follow every order I'm given.
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. Maybe you ain't. I don't know.
I really need to get those kids over here.
This is it. Keep a cool head and everything should be fine.
Hey, buddy, we're here to pick up the shipment.
I don't speak English. Fuck off. Hey, amigo, let's make this easy. I just want to give the stuff to my boss and go home.
I don't let anyone in here until I get the word. There's something wrong about you. Get out of the truck real slow.
Nico, looks like we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Shoot these commies.
It's you on me!
Okay, listen, there's a truck waiting for us. It's under the overpass off Catskill Avenue. Drive us there.
Shit, you seen any choppers? Any birds been in the sky?
I didn't pick you for a helicopter enthusiast.
Fuck you, I ain't. I just keep thinking these choppers is following me, that's all. The feds are watching my every move. I flip out even when I'm outside.
Keep your head. Things ain't even started yet. What are we doing?
Taking a shipment of coke from some Russians before they can sell it to the enchiladas. I'm paranoid because we especially don't want to get caught on this one. We get caught and everyone will be coming after us. The feds will throw away the key. The Russians and the enchiladas know we was fucking them over.
Hell,
our own family might come after us for fear we'll turn states.
Hey, man, this familiarity is getting to me. I'm a friend of Ray's. I'm part of the family. Shit, man. I'm just the hired help. I'm the fucking immigrant maid cleaning up your guy's shit. I ain't part of no family. I'm an independent contractor.
Sure, sure, I get that. Whatever makes it all make sense in your head. Family's a way of saying we ain't gonna fuck each other. At least that's what it's meant to mean. All I care about is that you're loyal enough to get the jobs done and not turn states.
I'll get the job.
All right, this is the truck.
They're gonna let us take the coke with this truck then, are they?
That's the plan. Whether it works or not remains to be seen. You know something? I would've liked Ray to be on this job instead of me. But there's some things that he ain't trusted with.
I don't think I'd trust him to send me on another job after the shit he had me doing.
After all of that, you guys didn't even get the diamonds. That wasn't a successful operation by any way you look at it. I'm hoping that this endeavor is gonna be more fruitful.
For the record, I did everything I was meant to do. The problem was Ray's planning. And the amount of people involved. Too many people wanted that dice. No one was ever going to end up with it.
Well, a lot of people want to get a hold of this merchandise as well. By your logic, that means it's going to end up dissolving into the Humboldt River. I don't want that to happen.
Me neither. Maybe if we want it more than anyone else, we'll be able to hang on to it.
It's gonna take more than wanting it real bad. It's gonna take a clear head. Ray's a greedy rat. He wants this stuff more than anyone else. But that don't mean he's gonna get it. He's got his eyes on my position. The skipper's too, I'm sure. Wanting it and getting it are two different things, though. Every move he makes is so obvious. It's disgusting to see him trying to sleaze his way up the ladder.
His moves might be easy for you to see, but maybe they're working. Maybe he's getting somewhere. He definitely knows a lot of people.
Shit, if anyone does start listening to Ray's shit, then I could be in some trouble. I'm hoping that day don't come.
This week.
Jesus, the damn cops.
Make me late to school.
This is it. Keep a cool head and everything should be fine.
hanging around. Story of my life.
Buddy, we're here to pick up the shipment.
I don't speak English. Fuck off.
Hey, amigo, let's make this easy. I just want to give this stuff to my boss and go home.
Here.
There's more of these guys coming after us! Cocaine to ourselves now, Phil!
You handled yourself real good back there. Kept your head. That's a valuable trait. Thank you. See you later.